I don't get it. Hey guys, you see the beautiful graphics, the pretty graphics anyways, the beautiful sound. You're thinking this is going to be a really cool, neat looking game. Then you hear something like this happen.
I had kidney stones and you visited me in the hospital. After the operation, when I was still half submerged in anesthetic, your outline and your speech both blurred. Now my stones have grown into an island and made their escape, and you have been rendered opaque by the car of a drunk.
And that is Dear Esther in a nutshell. You can't run in this game. You can't jump in this game. You have one pace, slow, and that's just to make the game longer. The graphics are hit and miss throughout the whole game. There's no audio things to read. There's no books to read. The guy just talks randomly once in a while. Areas where you think you can go to, like I'm going to show you here in a second, like the ship, you can't explore in it. There's no way in it. There's no exploring. The path looks wide open, but the path itself is very linear. Example, I went into this cavern type of thing, walked down there and see what it was. Dead end. As big as it was a dead end. There was nothing down there. Not even a cool looking place of the game that make you think, hey, something could have happened here. Nothing. In the area of the open area, tried to explore once just out of the blue. I get stuck in between four little rocks, just like this. Four little rocks. No way out. I had to reset the game. Then you run into something like this. I mean, this is kind of cool. The audio is kicking in. It's dark, spooky. Here comes the voices, you know?
Hey. Well, Dominic had experienced this, but had realized it was his own shoreline, as am I. Just as I am becoming his island, so he became his Sisyphus, retreating
cool.
Into the burning synapses, the stones,
this is
the
nice. Wait. Now what if I end this review like this? Just cut it off. What if I just gave this a 4.5 out of 10 and I'm just...